In this video lecture, we will discuss the anatomy of smooth muscle. Let's start with the location for smooth muscle. It's in the walls of hollow organs. For example, the walls of blood vessels, the walls of the digestive tract, the walls of certain structures of the respiratory tract, and the reproductive tract. There are lots of locations for smooth muscle in the human body, and the location of that muscle will dictate its specific function. So if we are speaking of the smooth muscle lining the walls of the digestive tract, the function of that smooth muscle is peristalsis. This process allows stuff to move through your digestive tract. The smooth muscle lining parts of your respiratory tract will, for example, allow for bronchoconstriction and bronchodilation. Another example is the smooth muscle lining the walls of the blood vessels. This allows some blood vessels to vasoconstrict and vasodilate. So those are a few examples of location and function for smooth muscle. Next, I would like to provide you with an overview of smooth muscle structure. We will begin with what is called striations. When you look at this picture, we don't see any striations. In other words, there are no lines running through this muscle. Hence, smooth muscle is not striated, it is smooth. As to whether or not smooth muscle has gap junctions, that is dependent on the type of smooth muscle. We will return to that concept later. We also cannot classify all smooth muscle as either myogenic or neurogenic, as that too depends on the type of smooth muscle. We can, however, classify smooth muscle as involuntary muscle. And in the earlier material, you learned that both smooth and cardiac muscle are part of the autonomic nervous system, the ANS. So neurotransmitters are released by what structure? Because it's the autonomic nervous system, neurotransmitters are released via varicosities. So let's focus on the ANS for a moment. Does this diagram look familiar? If the parasympathetic nervous system is dominating, what neurotransmitter is released from the preganglionic fiber? Acetylcholine. What type of receptor will acetylcholine bind to on the postganglionic cell body and or dendrites? Nicotinic cholinergic. If the sympathetic nervous system dominates, what neurotransmitter is released from the preganglionic fiber? It's still acetylcholine. And what receptor is acetylcholine binding to on that postganglionic fiber? It's still nicotinic cholinergic. So now let's go back to the parasympathetic nervous system dominating. What neurotransmitter is released from the postganglionic fiber? Acetylcholine. What receptor will acetylcholine bind to on the effector? Muscarinic cholinergic. And in this case, we're talking about smooth muscle, so what is the effector we are talking about? Remember, effectors are always muscle and glands, so it must be smooth muscle. Now switching back to the sympathetic nervous system dominating, what neurotransmitter is released from the postganglionic fiber? Epinephrine and or norepinephrine. And then what receptor will epinephrine and norepinephrine bind to on the effector? Adrenergic. What is the effector organ in this case? Smooth muscle.